World War II veteran returns to Beloit after being shot and killed in action.
Sergeant Robert McCarville's remains were recovered from Papua New Guinea and identified using DNA. Gabriella Becerra shares what his return means to his loved ones. Gabby?
Sergeant Robert McCarville has four living siblings and many nieces and nephews who didn't expect to hear their loved one was coming home from war. His niece, who never had the chance to know her uncle, shares what it means to have him home.
What are the odds of him ever being able to be identified and bring him home?
The thought of an uncle she never met coming home from World War II never seemed real to Maureen McCarville.
Almost like a fairy tale, you know. We had this uncle and we had this picture and we had these stories. Well, now we actually have our uncle.
Sergeant John McCarville signed up to serve in the Army after Japan bombed Pearl Harbor.
What happened was when they were on the island, they came upon a very well camouflaged nest of gunners, Japanese gunners, and they got into like a pretty ferocious fight. And my uncle was one that got killed.
His remains were identified using DNA, and McCarville will be buried in Beloit next to his parents.
For most veterans, it's a closing point. It's a closure for the family. But even more with this wonderful program of finding remains and bringing back the unknowns, it's probably even more. I'm sure it means more.
McCarville will receive full military honors at his funeral on Saturday. Veteran Mark Van Zant has served in honor guard ceremonies.
I'm saying thank you for your service, and that's what we want to honor them truly, because they've given the ultimate sacrifice to protect us.
McCarville says her uncle's return will bring closure to the family.
This kind of brings it all together.
McCarville's niece shared that her uncle's wish was to be buried with his comrades if he was killed in duty, so his sister didn't want to move him, but the military explained that all of his comrades are going home too. McCarville's funeral is tomorrow in Beloit.
Gabby, thank you.
Mm-hmm. All right.